Beware of illegal video cassettes. Check whether this video cassette carries a genuine label hologram. Video piracy is a crime. Do not accept it. Demand a genuine cassette from your video store. Poor quality illegal video cassettes reduce your viewing pleasure and jeopardize future film production. When in doubt, telephone the Federation Against Copyright Theft, FACT, on 0181 568 6646. Or in the case of the Republic of Ireland, 01 6777 071.
When you rent or buy a video, you need to know that the film you choose is suitable for the audience at home. To help you understand what the film is like, you can look at the certificate it has been given. This film has been classified as 12. That means this film is unsuitable for anyone younger than 12. A film with a 12 certificate may contain stronger moments of violence or references to sexual experience. There may also be swear words that you wouldn't find in a PG film. It is an offence to supply a video classified 12 to anyone below that age. Video certificates are there to give you the chance to make the right choice. Thanks for listening.
I'm off. Oh, I've got that video Rebecca wanted. Only cost a fiver from that bloke down the market.
Great. It's not even out yet. She'll love it.
I know. See you later.
See you.
Take care.
Bye now.
As children, Prince Derek and Princess Odette weren't exactly the best of friends. But as they grew up, they began to see each other differently. Then, before their kingdoms could unite, Odette was stolen away by an evil enchanter. Transforming her with a powerful spell.
Wherever you are, I'm gonna find you.
The Swan Princess. An exciting, delighting, magical, musical fantasy.
Beauty and glamour and breeding a match.
Princesses on parade.
Featuring the voices of John Cleese.
To the rescue, mademoiselle.
Sandy Duncan.
Queen Carmithruvia. Excuse me.
Jack Palance.
Don't give me that look, missy.
And Stephen Wright.
No.
Now, Odette the Swan and her faithful friends from the forest are searching for Prince Derek.
Slow down!
To reveal the Swan's secret, a spell that can only be broken by looking beyond her feathers to find the beauty inside.
Hello, Derek.
Odette.
Come share a timeless tale of legendary love. The Swan Princess, an enchanting animated adventure.
After a lifetime in the public eye, former First Lady Tess Carlyle retired to her Ohio home. But she did not go quietly.
What do we look like, waiters? Are we a bunch of waiters?
Just ask the Secret Service agent.
I can't do three more years of this.
Guarding Tess.
We are going to the opera in Columbus.
Mrs. Carlyle, that emergency alarm is abused.
That alarm belongs to me, and I will use it by God any time I see fit.
How is she these days? What's she like?
I guess you could say she's several different personalities in one.
Well, one of her personalities called the White House last night and asked the president if he could arrange for you to stay on with him.
The president.
We are not leaving this house until you are seated properly with your seatbelt firmly fastened.
Nope.
You
It's the worst assignment there is.
I need a price check and Lasur baby peas.
They're on special today, 2 for $59.
Copy that, Doug, but I believe we've lost interest in peas. Repeat, lost interest in peas.
Do be kind enough to get my ball.
I'm a Secret Service agent, Mrs. Carlisle, not a caddy.
I told her, you want that ball, you go funny yourself.
Come on, what are you, crazy?
I'd be very careful if I were you, agent.
Doug. Telephone.
Please hold for the president.
How are you?
I'm fine, and you?
Well, I'm not too good. I'm having a damn Tess Carlisle problem. Maybe you and I know what a pain in the butt she is, but this woman is a national treasure.
I wouldn't tick her off. A couple of more phone calls to the White House and you'll be...
guarding my dog. You understand what I'm saying?
Go.
Doug! Doug, she took off!
Tell them they're just out joyriding again. It's not a problem.
Seven well-trained, heavily armed men can't take care of one little old lady.
Damn! You should have a martini. You should, better yet, give a tired old widow a break.
Shirley MacLaine.
With all due respect, why me?
Because I like you, Douglas.
Please hold for the president.
Nicolas Cage.
I don't get it myself. One day she calls me, says she can't live without you. Next day she's calling almost in tears. You know, maybe you two have some kind of sicko thing going on.
No, sir.
Guarding Tess.
I'm counting on you, and so's the country.
In 1788, King George entered the 28th year of his glorious reign.
I wish you the best of health, Father.
Wish me. You wish me death, you plump little cuckoo.
It was an age of nobility.
Mrs. King.
Mr. King.
A time of harmony.
You're a good little woman, Mrs. King, and we have been happy.
It was a monarchy destined to endure.
Stop! Long live the king!
But destiny would have to wait.
George!
We are in company.
Mind your own business.
He was all powerful.
If Her Majesty would just lift your leg.
I'm the king, you lift my leg.
One, two, three, four, one.
But he wasn't quite all there.
Hello there, Georgie boy.
I want you to hand over Gibraltar to Spain and see if you can get Minorca in return.
I'm a physician, sir.
Well, then you should have no difficulty.
What would happen if the king were ill?
Your Royal Highness would have to be declared regent. King in all but name.
Is he ill?
Well, he's not well.
Thought it would be so. In England, always the prince hates the king.
Is that why he's mad?
Do you think that you are mad?
I hear the words, so I have to speak them.
There have been questions in the House.
Parliament, you'll do nothing, Mr. Pitt, nothing. I'm not mad.
I was given to understand you might be able to cure His Majesty.
Well, I can cure him, Mr. Pitt. I'm just not sure what from.
I make the weather by means of mental powers.
The king is incapacitated.
If a few colonists in America can send him packing, why can't we?
He is to rule in your place.
By whose authority?
Now is the time, Charles!
The Samuel Goldwyn Company and Channel 4 Films present Nigel Hawthorne.
It was something he ate.
Helen Mirren, Ian Holm, Amanda Donahoe, Rupert Graves, and Rupert Everett as the Prince of Wales.
Smile in vain. It's what you're paid for.
The Madness of King George.
How is Your Majesty?
Fat lot, you care.
God save the king. And so on.
Directed by Nicholas Heitner, from a screenplay by Alan Bennett. The Madness of King George.